So as it would appear, Boruto and Kagura are locked in battle, and it doesn't seem like there's any sight of the end in sight yet. But we do know that there's going to be a lot of interesting things that take place during this next episode. What's going on, all you Boruto fans? I'm Predictable60 here, bringing you guys the next prediction for episode 31 of Boruto. And of course, we have these two, I guess, I wouldn't say juggernaut characters, because Boruto's not really a juggernaut and neither is Kagura, but he is an excellent swordsman, and he is going to go going against a very skilled person such as Boruto. And like we've seen previously in the episodes, that we've seen Boruto pull out some secret weapons that we hardly knew he had. And of course, we do have to think that Naruto did train him, but some of the jutsu that Boruto has learned and has used, we can't really say that Naruto taught him that. It has to be something more that Boruto either taught himself or learned during training with someone other than Naruto. But who knows, Boruto may have done this type of training with Naruto. He may have learned this stuff with Naruto. I can't say for sure if he did or did not, but I mean, in my opinion, I don't know. I like to say that he didn't learn this with Naruto, because I mean, you gotta think, Boruto has other friends now, so, and Naruto just seems busy, so it doesn't really tell you exactly who Boruto would have got most of his training from. Now, of course, we did see in Naruto Shippuden in the last episode, we saw them two kind of trainings, not really, but I mean, it was something, that just seems like basic fighting styles. I mean, that's about it. I don't really see that there was any type of jutsu learning in there, but, you know, like I said, for those of you who read the manga, there might be something that shows that Naruto has taught Boruto more things than we have seen so far in the episodes that we currently know that Boruto knows how to do. So with the epic fight taking place between Boruto and Kagura, we have yet to see anything really unfold between these two. Now, a lot of people would like to say that Kagura is only doing this stuff because Shizuma has influenced him and has this kind of guilt trip that he has over Kagura, but that's not the case, because Kagura even said himself that that's not the reason. He's not listening to Shizuma for the reason that, you know, oh, well, maybe this guy has some type of guilt trip over me. It's not that. It's just the fact that Shizuma has always been there for him and always has tried to, like, let him know that, you know, he's still a person. He's still a human being. He's not some monster that he makes himself out to be. And, you know, he's a good kid. It's basically just that. And, you know, he's just always kind of been there for him, I guess, as a kind of a role model to him. And I guess Kagura just, that's what Kagura is really using as his means to listen to Shizuma. But I don't see that Kagura would have to let that be a reason to hold him back and hold him to where he's like, oh, I can't do anything against this guy because he's about, you know, I still think that Kagura needs to be his own person. But at the same time, he still feels that he's been in Yugura's shadow, his I guess grandfather, I think is what it was. His grandfather, he's still been in his grandfather's shadow because he used to be the what they call or claim to be a killer. But of course, we all know Yugura was one of the tailed beasts, and he was not a bad person. He was a good guy, and they just made him out to be this bad person just because he was a Jinchuriki. And I guess that's just kind of the story that got mixed up to where Kagura doesn't understand fully what happened with his grandfather. So it's just basically that. And I mean, I just think that Boruto may actually be able to talk some sense into him, because it seems that Boruto has a way of convincing people that, you know, there's a better way to solve your issues, and, you know, there's a better way to deal with your personal affairs rather than trying to do something bad or kill somebody over it. You know, it's just, you gotta just make sure you do things to where it satisfies you but also can, like, benefit you as well. It's not just for one, you know, revengeful purpose or just anything like that. So that's one of the things that I value about Boruto, is that he tries to talk people into, you know, reasoning with themselves rather than, you know, having them do something to where it's going to cause harm to someone else. So that's one of the good things about Boruto. And of course, we know Naruto was pretty much the same way. And of course, it didn't always have to resort to fighting, but that just happened to be what ended up coming, what it came down to most of the time. Now, when it comes to Kagura and Boruto being strong, I don't really want to say that either one is stronger than the other. I would say that they're evenly matched, but at this point in time, it seems like Kagura has the upper hand just because they are in the Hidden Mist Village, and a lot more things kind of just go in his favor after the fact that they have this Hidden Mist Jutsu to where only certain people can see through it, and I mean, or at least navigate through it. I won't say see through it, but, you know, I'd say that they can navigate their way through it. Boruto is having a hard time being able to combat Kagura for the fact that he can't see. It's hard to see for Boruto, and Kagura already knows how to navigate himself through this mist, and it just makes it kind of work in his favor. I mean, and the fact that he has a sword, I mean, He has an extension of his own arm. He doesn't have to get as close to Boruto, and he does possess more jutsu. So that being said, it's just kind of hard to say who's stronger here, but I mean, from the way it looks to any normal person, obviously it's going to look like Kagura has the upper hand, but we know that Boruto is going to pull some rabbit out of his hat by some sheer force of will or sheer force of luck, however you want to put it, and just win this fight. I mean, I think they're not really going to defeat one another. They're probably, if it's anything, I think it's going to end in a draw, or it's going to end with them just negotiating it out. They're not going to really be fighting without talking. It's going to be mostly just a combination of the two, and it's just going to be more Boruto trying to like plea and beg and just kind of like just reason with Kagura, and it's just going to kind of seem like, well, Kagura is probably not going to listen to you because he's so invested in Chizuma. So it's just hard to say as of right now as to how this battle will end. But of course, you people know that you, my fans, you Boruto fans, can leave your comments down below in the comment section as to what you think will happen, because like I always mention, it's always interesting to see what you guys think versus what I think, so that we can compare ideas and we can see who has some similar interests or similar ideas, similar opinions, rather than someone who just kind of feels like they know what's going to happen. So it's good to just compare and see what we both think and see what happens in the actual episode. But of course, you guys can do that in the comment section below. If you guys want to go the extra mile, then you're more than welcome to share this video and like it, so that you guys can go ahead and give us more of what we need to get the views out there, and just to make us feel better about our videos, I guess, if you want to put it that way. But anyways, if you guys are fans of Boruto, go ahead and subscribe and go ahead and click the bell symbol so you get notified about all the latest videos and Boruto content that will be coming to this channel. Until next time, guys, Unpredictable is signing off.